Andrea Corbet and chemistry professor Charley Liberko are revealing their true colors.
This is the dye in one part solvent, three parts water.
The colors of organic chemistry.
This is the dye in one half water, one half solvent.
Everybody loves colors, don't they? I haven't had any student come into any of my classes and say, no, that color changing stuff is boring.
These colors are at the heart of their Cornell Summer Research Institute project.
We are working with dyes. They make things change color. These dyes are specifically called something called solvatochromatic dyes. And all that means is that name basically means they will change their color depending on their environment. So depending on what liquid you put it in.
They have the challenge of researching a big question. What causes the dye molecules to change color?
We're not just interested in single molecules, we're interested in how the molecules interact with each other. So when you bring two molecules or 10 molecules together, they change their properties when they get next to each other.
Part of the study includes this instrument, which is a new model for the chemistry department. It's called a nuclear magnetic resonance spectrometer, or NMR. Corbet is using it to determine the purity of the dye she created.
The purer a compound is, the better it's going to cooperate and react with its environment. So if this wasn't pure, it may not change color.
At the end of the 10-week institute, these two have big goals for their findings.
Well, my ultimate goal this summer and his is to have enough research and enough data and enough answers to write a publishable paper. And also the bigger picture is to have a lab that can be incorporated into the organic chemistry class, so students can actually do this.
Professor Liberko says undergraduate research is one of the most important educational components Cornell offers its students to prepare them for the future.
So having this institute is huge in the fact that it gives us a critical mass for doing research. You need enough students in enough different areas where they can sort of cross-pollinate ideas. And they really do that here. Cornell is a school where they are going to take a lot of different things from different areas and combine them. It's something we do really well, is to sort of go beyond our regular boundaries. The chemistry students don't just do chemistry, not just chemistry and biology, but they're interested in theater and they're interested in literature and they're interested in all kinds of areas, which makes them better chemists.
This is just one story detailing all of the summer research projects going on at Cornell College. Watch for others on the Cornell College News Center or follow us on Facebook for more information.